Hai. Do you have a Skoda Octavia Mark 2 with 1.4 liter petrol engine? On this vehicle has happened a timing belt failure. The tooth from the smaller timing belt are fell off, and probably there are bent valves, so that means removing the cylinder head to see what's the damage. I'm going to start by removing that cover plastics, also the air filter housing. I have removed the LPG injectors. The top plastic are 4 bolts with Torx 30. And also I have opened the bolts of the air filter. Now I can pull out. Now we can see the camshaft and also the inlet manifold. Now I'm going to remove the inlet manifold. I'm going to start by disconnect the wiring, disconnect the fuel injectors, the throttle body, evap valve, and then I'm going to open the bolts that hold the inlet manifold. Now that the wires are disconnected, I'm going to try to show you where are the bolts. We have one here, this one is the second one, under the injectors, third one, fourth, fifth, and over here is the sixth bolt. I'm opening the bolts with 12 angle M8 key. There are 6 bolts. Now the inlet manifold is free. Also I have disconnected the hoses from the petrol. Now this is a quick removing. Just press like this, little down and then up, and you can remove it. And this one is from the evap valve. There is one pin here, just press it, pull it up. Now to remove it all completely, I have removed the inlet manifold. Now we can see much more easier. There is a coolant hose that goes on the manifold. Now we can see it was leaking coolant from here. Also, now you can see the oil evaporator hose, and this is the MAP sensor that measures the pressure into the inlet manifold. That was also on the wiring. Now you can see I have removed this hose, and I am draining the coolant from that hose. So when I remove the cylinder head, I'm not going to mix the oil and the coolant. Now I'm moving at the other end. I'm going to remove the exhaust manifold. First I have to remove this aluminium heat shield. There are 3 bolts with 10 millimeter wrench. As you can notice, I have removed the ignition coils, also aluminium heat shield. Now I'm going to open the bolts with 12 mm wrench of the exhaust manifold. I have opened the nuts that hold the exhaust manifold. Now you can see it's moving, but they are at the lower side that hold the manifold. Now I'm going to disconnect the thermostat housing. I'm not removing the hole, only open the bolts and remove the cylinder head up. There are three bolts, two are here at the top, but the third one is from the lower side, and to remove it I have to remove the battery and the battery stand. I have removed the battery. Now you can see 3 bolts with 10 mm wrench, and then I'm going to remove the battery stand, and after that I can have access for the thermostat housing. I have removed also the gear shift mechanism. Now I have access to the bolt. I will try to show you, but it's very difficult. There is no space. Sorry, there is no space for the camera to show you where is the bolt, but it's from the lower side, you can touch it with the hand. The thermostat is now free. I can remove the expansion tank, make room for removing the rubber mounting. There is one bolt with 10 mm wrench for the window washer filler, and two bolts and one nut of the bracket for the evap system. Now I can raise the vehicle, remove the plastic cover under the engine, and I can remove the drive belt, remove the crankshaft pulley. I removed the lower plastic cover. Now I'm going to remove this side one on the right side of the vehicle. Now you can see the drive belt. I'm going to use a 16 mm wrench to remove the drive belt. After removing the drive belt, I'm going to remove the crankshaft pulley, and I need a special key like this to lock the pulley and open the bolt. Bolt is removed with a 21 mm key with 12 angles. Now I can remove this lower plastic cover for the timing belt. There are 3 bolts with 10 mm wrench. One is here, the other one is behind the tensioner, and the third one is on the aluminium mounting, and there are 2 fast clips on this side. Now I can see the timing belt, and I'm going to open this bolt to release the tensioner of the timing belt. I'm going to lower the vehicle, support the engine, and remove the rubber mounting. I have supported the engine. Now I can start removing the rubber mounting. The rubber mounting has 2 bolts with 18 mm wrench, 2 bolts with 16 mm, and 1 bolt with 13 mm. I have also removed the aluminium mounting. There were 4 bolts with 16 mm wrench. Now I'm going to open these bolts with 5 mm hex wrench that are holding the camshafts, and after that I can remove the cylinder head. I have removed the bolts, and don't forget this bolt with 10 mm wrench that holds the protective plastic for the timing belt. Now I can pull up the camshafts. Now we can see the timing belt failure. Now we can see tooths are missing. Next is to remove the cylinder head bolts. They are with 12 angle M12, and also I forgot to remove the two bolts of the exhaust manifold. Now I'm going to show you. There are these two bolts that hold the exhaust manifold. They are on the bracket. They are with 12 angle 10M10. I'm going to remove them now, and then I can remove the cylinder head. Now the exhaust manifold is removed from the cylinder head, and just to open the 10 bolts with 12 angle M12. I have removed the cylinder head. Now I can see here and over here I can see marks on the piston, also on this piston. Almost on every piston I have marks of hitting the valves. That means they are all damaged, so I will have to replace the exhaust valves, all 8, and I will have to check for the inlet valves. This is the cylinder head. Now you can notice that I have removed the inlet valves, and they are pretty damaged. Also you can see the exhaust, they are very very inside. They are damaged even more than the inlet. So that means replacing all 16 valves and taking the cylinder head to a machine specialist. The cylinder head is disassembled. Here we have new valve, intake and exhaust, and now the cylinder head is going to a machine specialist. I have received the cylinder head from the machine specialist. The valve seats are being machined. I have new valves. Valves were also machined. Now I'm going to install them. The cylinder head was also washed. Now I can install first the rubber seals for the valves, and then I can install the valve and install the springs with a special tool. I'm using a little oil and I'm pressing the seals very easily. Now I can install the valve, and with special tool I'm going to compress the springs and install the pins to secure the springs. I have installed the valve, installed the springs. Now the cylinder head is ready to be installed into the vehicle. Here I have a new gasket for the cylinder head, just to clean the engine block, and I can install the cylinder head. I have cleaned the engine block with water sandpaper. It's clean, and also I have turn the bolts all the way in and all the way out, so to be sure they are moving easily and not to have problem with the tightening. And now I'm ready to install the cylinder head. I have installed the cylinder head. Now I have to tighten it with a special torque wrench, and these are the specifications for tightening. First 50 Newton meters, 30 Newton meters, and two times with 90 degrees. And this is the pattern for the tightening sequence. After tightening the cylinder head, I can start installing the hydraulic tappets and also the camshaft followers, and then I can install the camshafts. I have put a little silicone so it can create like a gasket. Before I install the camshaft cover, I'm putting two bolts with M8 to lock the camshafts, and they are for setting the timing. I have tightened the camshaft and now I can install the new timing belt kit. First I'm installing the small timing belt and smaller tensioner. We have bolt also for that. I'm using a 6mm hex wrench and I'm going to turn it anti-clockwise. Until the pointer I should stop here, and now I can tighten it with 13mm wrench. That one is set, the pins are moving easily, the timing of the camshaft is set. Now to insert the big timing belt for the crankshaft, on this pulley you can notice that this tooth here has it's smaller, and that's the timing, that's the mark for the timing. And also there is a mark over here on the engine, and they need to be aligned. This is the timing. Now I can install the rollers, also the tensioner, and I can install the timing belt. I have installed the timing belt, the new tensioner and new idler pulley. Now I'm using also a 6mm hex wrench, and now I'm turning clockwise until I set the tensioner, and I can tighten it with 13mm wrench. I have set the tension. Now I can install the aluminium mounting with 4 bolts, and I can install the rubber mounting also to connect the to support the engine with the vehicle. Now the engine is supported on the vehicle. I can install the exhaust manifold. I have installed the exhaust manifold. They were 9 bolts with 12mm wrench. Now I can install the aluminium heat shield, 4 bolts, 10mm wrench. Next I'm going to install the inlet manifold. Inlet manifold are holding 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bolts with 12 angle M8. Now I have installed inlet manifold, and I'm going to start connecting the wires and also hoses. On this side there is a hose for the LPG for vacuum brake, also for the LPG system. This is for the coolant. Connect the injectors, connect the sensor, map sensor for the pressure into the inlet manifold. Also connect the oil evaporator and the hose of the oil evaporator. Now you can notice I have connected some wires, some hoses, connected the throttle body, evap valve, evap hose, fuel injectors, install the filter for the tank ventilating, also the expansion tank, connected the fuel line, connected the heater for oil evaporator, also map sensor over here. These are from the LPG injectors. Now I can install on this side, I can install the battery stand. I have connected also the thermostat, I forgot to mention it, thermostat housing. Now I can install the gear shift mechanism, and I can install the battery stand, battery. Then I can raise the vehicle and finish the work from the lower side of the engine. I have installed the battery stand, connected the gear shift mechanism, also installed the spark plugs, ignition coils. Now I'm going to raise the vehicle to finish the work from the lower side of the engine, and then I will install the air filter and the battery, and I can start the engine. On the lower side I have two bolts, I have to install two bolts from the exhaust mounting. I have to install the plastic cover for the timing belt. I have installed the plastic cover, also the crankshaft pulley, tighten it with 21 mm wrench with 12 angles. Install the drive belt for the alternator and for the AC. Put the two bolts for the exhaust mounting. Now I can install the plastic cover under the engine, and also this plastic cover at the right side of the vehicle. I'm changing the oil in the oil filter. The plug is 19 mm wrench, and the filter can be opened with 24 or 27, depends on the manufacturer of the filter. I have drained the coolant, also changed the filter. Now I can install the lower protective plastic under the engine, and I can lower the vehicle, finish the work from the top side of the engine. Now I can lower the vehicle. I have installed the top cover plastic for the timing belt, also for the ignition coils, 4 bolts Torx 30. Install the air filter housing, it's very easy, just on the fast clips press down. I'm going to replace the air filter. Now to install the top cover of the air filter, refill with oil, refill with coolant, and install the battery, I can start the engine. I have installed the battery, everything is connected. Now I can start the engine for the first time. I have oil pressure. Now the steering wheel light will stay illuminated until the vehicle starts moving, and when it's reach more than 20 kilometers per hour, it's going to it will shut off alone this steering wheel light. The steering wheel works, but until the car reaches 20 kilometers per hour it will be illuminated. We can check the work of the engine. The engine has started right away. Now this steam that is coming off is from the grease, from the oil, because it was working. I'm going to leave the cap open of the coolant until the engine reaches normal working temperature, and after that I will refill if needed, and I'm going to close the expansion tank. Now you can hear some noise from the hydraulic tappets, but after the engine will work a while, it's going to lose that that sound. It's going to overfill like it should the tappets, and they won't be hearing. The vehicle has been working for a while. Now you can see the engine is working more, I don't know how to explain it, more calm. The voice from the hydraulic tappets is lost. The coolant is okay. Everything works fine. This means I'm finished. If you like to see more videos, please subscribe to my channel, like my videos, and thank you for watching.